gave on good morning to one and all present here. The topic of today's presentation is personality development and classroom management. Before I start, do we really know that what personality actually is or what personality management actually is? Anybody? So it would be more of an open session and it should be like an interactive forum. I want teachers to also participate. If you have any queries, I'd be more than happy to help you all. So what personality development actually is? Do we really think that we are well dressed up and we are Dinjan, so that is our personality? No, it's not. It is the improvement in all these spirits of our life, be it our characteristics, be it our beliefs, disbeliefs, any trait of ours as a matter of fact. So along with this, we will be also discussing that how personality development is related to confidence management and classroom management. Confidence is way too important. We all are teachers and we have to be confident enough in front of our students. So this is how we go about it.
Integrity is helping other people or being noble towards other people.
So in classroom also, we should be helpful enough, and amongst us also, among teachers also, we should be helpful enough. It should not be like that, that if a teacher is asking for help, so we should say, no, I'll not do your work. It should not be like that. We should say, okay ma'am, okay sir, I'll see. If I get time, I'll be more than happy to help you out. Then acceptance. We should be ready to accept everything. Ups and downs come in our way, in everyone's way. And all the days are not same. So ups and downs always come. So we should be ready to accept things in a positive manner. We should not say that, oh my god, this has happened and I won't be able to handle this. Then discipline. Quite important and most important part of this character trait. We should be disciplined. Unless and until we will not follow discipline, we won't be able to be the same to our students. So it is very important we should be disciplined enough, and dedication also. We should be dedicated enough towards our work. Whatever roles and responsibilities we have got, we should be more than happy to help. It should not be like that we should keep on brooding. No, today sir has given me these many jobs, I won't be able to do that. So this is all. Then behavioral traits. The way we are conversating with other people plays a very important role. How we are talking to the other person. Now whatever we are speaking, that matters a lot. No matter we are well dressed up, but this mouth that speaks a lot about yourself. If we are speaking ill words, let's suppose we are not speaking ill words in front of the same person. But even if we are cribbing about that person with some other, let's suppose third person. So that might also affect our personality. Our personality will become negative just because anyhow that teacher or any person as a matter of fact will get to know that he or she was cribbing about you. Then interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills is how good we are in communicating with other people. Our voice speaks everything. Whatever we are talking to other person, whatever we are speaking with other person, so that's how. So we should be careful about the words that our mouth is going to speak. Think before you speak, it is said. So we should always give it a second thought. We should always think before whatever we are speaking. Just because you never know at what time the other person might feel bad. At times it happens that out of nowhere we just say something. And later on we, regret. I should not have said that. So why should not you have thought on the very first place itself? So you should have thought on the very first place so that it should not affect the other person. Then communication skills, very important. We ask our students to speak in English, but unless and until we don't portray a positive message in front of them, they won't be able to speak in English. Everybody wants to conversate in his or her native language. No offense to anybody's native language, but what procedure we should follow in school is, we should conversate either in English. If a student is facing any sort of difficulty in understanding English, we should make all of us know Hindi. We should make him or her understand in Hindi first, and then we should ask him or her to just try and speak in English. All these students are not of the same pace. So we should ask these students just to try. We are there to correct them. So that's all. Then leadership qualities. It is very important for us to be a leader. So we should portray the same in front of our students also. If we will have the leadership qualities, if we will have something to do, so we should teach our students also that you should never say no to anything. Then stress and time management, very important. We make lesson plans. This is the reason why we make lesson plans. We manage time. Why don't we give 1 month to a particular chapter? If we will give 1 month to a particular chapter, then we will not be able to manage time in an efficient manner. So we will not be an efficient teacher. If we will not be able to manage the time in an efficient manner, so this is the reason that why we make lesson plans. Why we make lesson plans on weekly basis, so that we also should get to know that what all has to be covered on what day. And 40 minutes, we have a period of 40 minutes. So what all should be covered in that particular period. So this is how we go about it. Then attitude. Attitude once again is an important part. What is attitude? How we are behaving in front of other person. So we should always portray a positive attitude. At times it happens that we are sad, we don't feel like speaking to the other person, we are sad. Why we are portraying it to the other person, that we are sad? Will he be able to accept what is the difficulty you are facing? Do you really think that he will be able to help you out in your problem? Do you really think? He will be least bothered about your problem, to be honest. So why to show it to other people? Just keep it to yourself, it is your problem. You will be... Other than you, nobody will be able to help you in a better way. You are your own master. A win-win situation. Win-win situation is, we should always think saying that we are going to win a situation. It should not be like that if we are teaching our students. So it should not be like that, that we are not able to teach our students. We should always have a positive attitude, and we should think that we can teach our students in a better manner. We should give them examples. We should give them live examples. That's it. Keep the end in mind. Very important. Keep the end in mind means we should know our deadline. We should know where we have to put a full stop. Be it in any aspect. Be it in any relationship, any friend circle, in our class, full stop. With students also is important. At times it happens that teachers, they try to discuss things with other students also. So this is how, where you keep to, where you need to put a full stop. You should know your limits. These students on the other side should also know their limits. That what is right for them, what should they really speak to the teacher. At times it happens that students, they come up to you and they speak anything they want to. So if this might be the case that you have not maintained distance with that student, this is the reason that that student might have got this much liberty to come, to walk up to you and to speak that. So we should always know that what is our deadline, and we always need to put a full stop on that. Now synergize all these points, synergize and make a positive attitude. We all have different personalities. Now, it is very important for us to identify that what is the criteria to identify our personality, and what all are the factors that basically define our personality. We will be discussing after that. First of all, we will be discussing our personality and what category we fall in. There are nine types, main nine types. Do we have more types, but as of now we will be discussing only the nine main types. Now before starting the types of personality, we should always make our student understand that he too should have a personality. He too should have a role model so that he can look up to. Role model can be teachers, can be parents, or can be any actor, actresses, or any person as a matter of fact, any leader. So it is very important for us being teachers to make our child understand that this is the right age for them to choose their role model so that they can look up to that person and they can become the same. So our first type of personality is perfectionist. Perfectionist is what? Perfectionist, as the name itself suggests, something that is perfect, just perfect. We have no flaws in that. So perfectionists are people who are just perfect. They are realistic people and principled, highly principled people. So we also look up to some people. They can be our parents, they can be anybody, any leader. So this is what. So it is very important for us to understand that who a perfectionist is and what is the category we are falling into. So first one we discussed is perfectionist. Perfectionist is, as the name itself suggests, somebody who is just perfect. Super se bhi upar bhi se, somebody who is just perfect and on whose footprints we want to walk. We also have idols. So we need to make our students understand, our children understand, that they too have some personalities. They should also have an idol. When we were kids, we used to write an essay on your role model. So we need to make our students understand that it is good for them to choose a role model. So they can look up to that role model and they can see that what they should do and how they can become like that personality. They should not follow exactly the same thing. They should apply their brains also, but something of theirs they can follow just as a guideline. And then helpers. Helpers are people who are always ready to help others. So we should be helpers. That is also one of the personalities. Yes, there are teachers who are always, though all of us are, but yes, there are teachers who are proactive. If somebody falls down, so they just run quickly and they just help that particular child. So it is also a very important part. Then achiever. Achievers are generally people who are goal-oriented people. Like Sachin Tendulkar, we too should have some goal, and we should make our students understand that they should be goal-oriented. We should teach them that what is the need of studying, why we are teaching them, just for the marks? No. We should not teach our students this, that if you will get 100 out of 100, then you will be a good student. It shouldn't be like that. Then romantics. Romantics are people who are sensitive, not exactly romantic people, but romantics are people who are sensitive to others' feelings. So we should always, on a positive side, we should always understand the feelings of other people. It should not be like that a particular person is standing in front of us, he's saying something, and we are just listening from one ear and out from the other. It should not be like that. So we should be sensitive and we should try to understand others' problem. Though we are not able to help always, but sometimes we should at least try to understand. And we should be helping him towards others. Then thinkers. Thinkers are people who are curious and who are eager to learn things. these are things. So it is good to be a thinker, just because the more you think, the more you will add on to your personality. Then questionnaires. Questionnaires are responsible and trustworthy people. Adventurer. Adventure is somehow linked to adventure. So it is, in this we will be talking about adventurous people. Adventurous people are who are energetic people, who always want to do something new. We also decide with our friends, let's go on an adventure trip. So this is what. Leaders. Leaders are protective people who look after our country. So we need to understand this also, and we need to make our students understand that what is the importance of leaders. Nowadays, it is high time just because elections are going on. So this is also important. Then peacemakers. Peacemakers are good-natured and supportive people who support us in our ups and downs. Helpers, example, Mother Teresa, she was always a step ahead in helping people. Achievers, Sachin Tendulkar. Then peacemakers, Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Justice Anand. Now this part is very important, determinants of personality. We need to understand that what all are the factors that determine our personality. The previous stage was what personality we fall into or what category we fall into. But this is the determinants of personality. What are the factors that determine our personality? So we have four main factors. First one is biological factor. Second, family and social factors, cultural factors and situational factors. We will be starting with biological factors. Biological factors, they include hereditary. We have got about genes, transmission of characteristics from parents to children. Now it is quite important that the characteristics that our parents have, we tend to get something or the other from them. Maybe it is appearance, maybe something else, it can be anything. Then physical features, we tend to get some physical features, we are not exactly same, we all are different, but something or the other we tend to get from our parents. Then family and social factors, very important. Family and social factors means the way our nurturing has been done. The way our brought up has been, this also plays a very important role. The way our parents, they are bringing us up. So that is always going to reflect in our personality. Identification process, selecting an ideal person, already covered. It is important for us to select an ideal person so that we can just look up to that person and we can see what is the personality that particular person is holding, and just we can follow the same, and we can follow the same principles. It is better to follow the principles and apply your own ideas. Home environment, again brought up, the way you are being brought up, and socializing is also very important. It should not be like that we should just sit mom in just one closed room. We should always be proactive enough in interacting with other people. At times it happens that whenever we meet somebody, we should greet whenever we meet somebody. Even let the other person not greet you. It is a good habit, we should greet the other person. So if the other person is not talking, you can ask how, hey, hi, or how are you? But so it is good to socialize. Then cultural factors. This also plays a very important role in determining our personality. Most of us are from different regions. In different regions, different cultural principles are being followed. Every region has a different culture. Every region has a different tradition. So we all are, our personality has been built based upon our cultural factor. The way we are being brought up in that particular area. Now people from Assam, they have different appearance. The people from Uttar Pradesh, they have a different appearance, and so on. So cultural factors, they play a very important role. For example, the people of Australia, they are always considered to have an independent mindset. People of North Korea, they are considered to be somewhat aggressive in nature. They are to be. People of India, they have a competitive spirit. They always want to, you know, win that win-win situation. Then people of Japan, they are considered to be cooperative in nature. Then situational factors. Situational factors means based on the situation. Now we should always react based on the situation. Though the other person should not get to know that we are behaving in a negative manner. It might happen somebody scolded us. When we look at our parents, they used to scold us. So yes, we used to feel bad, but that too also we should take in a positive manner. That if our parents have scolded us, they might have done that for a particular reason. There might be something behind that. They might want us to do well in life. We scold our students, there is a reason behind it. Not because out of nowhere we want that. Just out of any aggression we want that. Just because we want to make their future bright. Similarly, most of us are parents. We also scold our children just because we don't want them to go in a negative path. Now, parental characteristics. A parent's personality directly impacts a child's personality quite often. So parents also, they need to portray a good example in front of their children. If they will be angry with their children, so the child also will not want to talk to his or her parents. Happy, we should always be happy in front of our parents. We should be happy in front of our parents, and on the other side, parents should also show a positive behavior towards their children. Importance of personality development. What are all the fields where personality development plays a very important role? First of all, we have already discussed it makes our attitude positive. We should always have a positive attitude rather than a negative attitude. A negative person will find something or the other in a positive thing. Helps him or her mark a mark of his own. Means we get to build our own identity. If we have a positive attitude, see, I carry a different identity. Ma'am might carry a different identity. Rakhi ma'am might carry a different identity. So if we are positive towards our personality, so that will for sure help us in building our own personality. And we are unique, everybody is unique from each other, maybe anything. See, appearance hardly matters. We should not say that the other person is beautiful or the other person is good or good looking. She wears beautiful suits daily, so she has a good personality. It has to do with your heart and soul also, and that should be pure. We should have good vibes towards others. We should have good feelings for others. It should not be like that we should keep on crying about others. Are you too icy? Are you too icy? And stuff. Reducing stress and conflicts. We might have noticed that whenever we think in a positive manner, that reduces your stress. Even if it is just a stress buster. A positive personality is a stress buster and you feel relaxed. We should think that no problem, this has happened. It is in our hands to improve that. So we should take it in a positive manner. Develop a positive attitude in life. Now, there are some skills that are very important in order to improve our personality. First, it is very important to know ourselves. So it is just like a mirror. We are our own mirrors. We need to identify our pros and cons. We need to identify our strengths and weaknesses. So it is rather than knowing other person. Nowadays what happens is, wo kya kar rahi hai, ye kya kar rahi hai. We are more into that. How much is the other person getting, or stuff like that, whatever. What is the other person teaching? You teach whatever you are supposed to teach. Don't look up to the other person. So it is very important to identify yourself, your failures, your strengths and weaknesses. If you will be able to identify your strengths and weaknesses, you will be able to rectify that. Bring positivity in your outlook. Very important. We need to bring positivity in our outlook. That will not only help us, but that will help the surroundings also. Our children, our other people, our colleagues have an opinion. We should always have some or the other idea. We should not shy. We should not feel shy that we are not able to portray our feelings in front of us. We all have right to speak. So we should always have, you know, something or the other to speak to other person. It should not be like that the person is standing mum and we are just speaking and the other person is even not listening to us. So it is not a good gesture. So it is always better to come up with ideas. It is always, you know, free. We should always feel free in order to speak in front of other person. Meeting new people also enhances our personality. How? We see a new person. First of all, whenever we see a new person, what do we do? Yes. We greet the other person, we smile. Then we see, wow, isne to kitne achhe kapde pehne. First of all, this is what we do whenever we meet a stranger or a new person. So, meeting new people makes our confidence level, we are able to interact with that particular person. So, meeting new people also enhances our personality. Just because we get to learn something or the other from that. If we are meeting a new person, so somehow I discuss it with other people also. I met this and this person, I go home and I tell my husband that I met this person and she was so. So we should always, you know, leave a positive feedback towards the other person also. So that he or she discusses about you at his or her place. Read more often and develop new interest. Yes, it is good to read more often. Just because the more we read, the more we get to know. It is studies unending. It is just that we are not sitting in classes. We teach our students. That is also a learning place for all of us. We get to know different types of students. We get to know different types of chapters. We also have to study. Before delivering our lecture, we also study. So that's it. Be a good listener. Very important. It is well said, listen more and speak less. Speak less and listen more. So listen to what the other person is saying. It should not be like that, a person is speaking and you just interrupted in between. Let the other person complete. Let the other person finish and then you can give your ideas. So that is a good point. Be a little fun. It should not be like that, all work, no play makes Jack a dull boy. We all might have heard since childhood, I have been listening this. All work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. Why do we have games period? Why do we have music period? So that we don't have to study the entire, especially our students. This is for our students that there should be some fun also. Why do we keep on organizing these activities? Fancy dress competitions, fairy competition, so that our students, you know, they somewhere, apart from these studies, they should do something extra. And they enjoy also doing that. In our fairy competition, little kids, they were enjoying like anything. So this is something related to fun. Be courteous. We should always be generous and helpful to other people. It is a good gesture. Work on your body language. Very important. It is very important for us to work on our body language. It should not be like that. We are talking to one person, the other person is talking and we are like... So we should pay attention to what the other person is speaking. It might be the case when somebody is speaking to us and we are not, we are not listening to that person, to what that person is saying. So he or she might feel bad. Similarly, vice versa may also happen. Check your attire. We'll be discussing about the attire once again. Check your attire. It is very important to understand that whatever you are carrying is portraying a positive example in front of your colleagues, in front of your children, and also in front of these students. Each and every person discusses about us. We are teachers, bachche bhi ghar pe jaake hamara discussion zarur karte honge. So it is very important for us to have a decent attire. Always, we can wear short, obviously not in school, but yes we do wear, but that should also be decent. Be yourself. It is always, recommended to carry your own identity. We should not copy others. Yes, we can see, we can make the other person as our idol, but we should be unique. We all are unique, we have different characteristics, we all have different features. So we should always be ourselves. We should not be copycats. The other teacher was wearing that, so I will also wear that. So we should be unique and we should be different from others. Confident, very important. If we are not confident in front of our what? In front of our students. So obviously they will somewhere down the line, they will also hesitate and they will also, not be able to focus on me. If we are not confident, if we are not delivering the lecture in a confident manner, they will also say, "Arey, ma'am, ko to kuch karwana hi nahi." Students, they discuss all this at their home, all this with their parents, all this with their friends. So we should always be confident in front of everybody, not only our students, but we should have a confident outlook. These are some points that positive mental attitude helps us in. It reduces our stress, increases collaboration, sparks proactive action, creates healthy work environment. Very important. Whenever we have a positive attitude, it creates a healthy environment. However, if we are in a negative attitude, so that creates a constipated environment. We don't feel like doing work. So whenever the environment is positive, whenever the environment is workaholic, so we also try to cope up with that environment and we also have that competitive spirit. That if she is doing so, I will also do that. It improves time management, builds better relationships. Yes, we do maintain relationships. We all have colleagues, we do have some relationship. We all are friends. Earlier we were not aware about each other. But since we joined this institution, so we started interacting with different kinds of people and this is how we get to know about others. So it is very important to interact with other people. We should all know that who all are the teacher. It should not be like that, that your music teacher kaun hai or chemistry teacher kaun and stuff like that. So no offense to you. And these are some hidden languages. What all they portray about you. If you see this first individual, see his posture. So it is very important to have a positive posture. If you are standing like this and thinking this, so it somehow shows that you are nervous. Then second, if you have a fake smile, it is a fake smile. You are hiding something, but you don't want to tell that. if you don't want to tell that, then how the other person will get to know that what all is going in your mind? Middle one, he has got a confident personality and a genuine smile, not a fake one, as we all can see. Fourth one, he has some sort of insecurity, whether he'll be selected. It might be the case that he might have come for an interview, so he has some sort of insecurity whether he might be selected or whether he'll be punished by the employer or something else. Then last one, we should never keep our hands like this. These are called drumming fingers. We'll be discussing that also. These are called drumming fingers. Either we can do this while sitting also, we should not sit like this. We'll be covering all those postures going forward. We all might have heard that actions speak louder than words. Whatever we do, they portray more than what we speak. Our body language speaks everything about ourselves. So, non-verbal symbols are more effective than verbal symbols. Now, these are some examples of the looks. This is the confident look, and look at the way he's standing. Such a big man is standing like this. Stress and tense look. Whenever we are stressed, I discussed this earlier also, that we should not portray in front of other people. Just because the other person has nothing to do with our tension, the other person will not help us in any manner. So we should always have a smile on our face. It should not be like that we just put our hand on our heads and sit like this in the entire classroom. So these are some examples. Then this is a very famous quotation. You are not completely dressed up until your face wears a smile. So it is always recommended to have a smile on your face. Some enemies are doing. Avoid such language. This can be avoided anywhere while you are appearing for any interview or while you are in a class or while you are sitting in your employer's office. Cross arms or legs. We should never sit like this. It's better to sit like this. Carrying books or papers across your chest. This is what we do. We are not carrying a baby with us. We are carrying a book or a file with us. Slant posture, we should sit upright. We should sit upright, so it should not be like this. Then sitting perched on the edge of the chair. We should use the entire chair. It should not be like that as soon as we sit and the chair will go back. Wringing hands is doing this all the time. This shows low confidence level. So either we can do this or we can do this. Then tapping foot. This should be avoided for a positive attitude. Rocking legs, at times it happens that we keep on doing this for a standing also. So this all should be avoided. Drumming fingers. Drumming fingers is whenever we are tapping. Whenever we are doing this, this also we should avoid in front of our seniors. Not only seniors, in front of everybody. This is not a good gesture. Then biting knees, be all. So this also should be.
SPG ma'am.
Yes sir.
Then someone save me. I'm not to stand like this.
Sir, not to stand like this when you are standing in your employer's office or when you are appearing for some interview. Yes, sir, you are not supposed to stand like this when you are sitting in front of an employer.
I don't do that just like this.
Yes. Sorry, sir.
This type of pose.
As if you are very bossy. This shows as if you are very bossy. This is what it doesn't, portray a positive thing in front of the others. Let's suppose you are appearing for an interview. You are going somewhere, you are going to Dibrugarh to appear for an interview. So will you stand like this in front of the interviewer?
Never.
This is getting.
Someone said this is the pose of Swami Vivekananda.
Sir, teachers can stand like this, but whenever we are standing in front of somebody who is senior to us, somebody who is very senior to us, for example, principal in our case, so we should avoid this. Do we stand like this in front of our principal?
Yes.
I don't know about others.
Thank you.
Then, some images. Don't cross your arms and legs. You should always sit like this. We all have appeared for an interview, so we know a few of these things. Always, it's always recommended to have an eye contact, but don't stare. Don't stare. You should have an eye contact, but we should never stare. The other person will think that, oh my god, I'm mad. This happens. This actually happens. Don't stare the other person. See, there is a difference between eye contact and stare.
staring is bhoolna. Eye contact means you are listening to that person completely. You are listening to what he is saying and you are just taking up his idea. So giving no eye contact might make seem you insecure. See, if the other person, if I am talking to, let's suppose, Rakhina, and I am looking at Archana, is it making any sense? It's not making any sense. So it's better to make eye contact, but I'll not stare Rakhina like this. Or any other person as a matter of fact. Don't do sit up straight. We should also not sit like this. It's not our home. So we should sit in our upright position. Don't stand too close. Very interesting. We should not stand too close to a particular person. We should know our limits. We should maintain distance. Not 1 hour distance, but more than that. So we should know what our limit is and we should not stand too close. If we have to say something to somebody, so obviously the other person has got ears and he or she will be able to listen. It is embarrassing if the more we move back, the more the other person comes forward. It happens. So let people have their personal space, don't invade it. The other person might get offended. The other person might feel bad that why he is getting so much into me, what exactly his intention is. He might, if we have a good intention, even if we have a positive intention, the other person might think that he or she has got a wrong intention. Now, we are done with personality management. Now we will be discussing how personality development is related to classroom management. How is it related to classroom management? Anybody? So let's make this more interactive. This is just a small one, so I won't take much time. Anybody? How personality development is related to classroom management? A teacher portrays... Yes, sir. Sir, KK, sir, please, you were asking something. Please go ahead. Sir, he had a question. KK, sir, he had a question.
Please. How can you make your class ready for to listen, hear, understand what you are going to say?
So you have to take everybody's attention first. That I'll be covering in this, that you have to start with a non-academic topic. You have to, start up with something that is relating to some fun or something like that. Then only when the entire class starts looking at you and when the entire class listens to what you are speaking, then you should start up with your lecture. So, and it is always better to show a positive personality in front of your students. You are just going and you are started writing something or the other, then the people also, they will do something or the other. Now, how classroom management is related to personality development? We all know in order to achieve better teaching goals, we have to portray a positive example in front of our students. Then only we can become an effective teacher. All of us, want to win that situation that yes, we are good teachers and we want to get good ACRs and stuff like that. So what you have to do for that? You need to understand why classroom management is important. What is classroom management first of all, and then we'll be discussing why is it important and how do we tackle different kinds of students. We see different kinds of students in our classes, so how to tackle all of them. Classroom management is ways of organizing the resources, pupils and helpers so that the teaching and the learning can process in an efficient and safe manner. Now teaching, we need to understand that teaching is also a two-way process. Teaching, how teaching is a two-way process? It should not be like that we are going and delivering the lecture and coming back. We need to ensure that our students, they are understanding or they are not understanding. We are not talking about the students who are coming first or second or who are in our list. We should focus on these students who are slow learners, not failures, who are slow learners. So we need to pull up their socks. We need to make them understand, yes, you are also a good student. We should not say that, arey nahi bhai, tum to kuch kar hi nahi paoge, and you are good for nothing. So we should not, develop that spirit in the mind of the student. If we will not portray something positive in front of our student, they will think that it is good for nothing. He will come back the other day just like that only. He will not even open his books at all. Why classroom management is important? Classroom management is important in order to develop everybody's attention so that each and every child listens to us. Now, if I'm delivering a lecture, let's suppose I'm delivering a topic to one of my class lecturers. So if these students are not listening, I might feel bad. I might feel bad because I have prepared for that lecture. I have prepared a plan for that lecture. This is the reason that why we make teacher's diary. Just because that is a detailed plan so as to what we will be teaching to our students. So it is very important to get everybody's attention and then start with the topic. There are some reasons why students misbehave for, and we need to keep these points in mind that how to again take everybody's attention and how to start over all it over. There are some mysterious chaps in the class. They are teaching and they are busy doing something or the other. So we need to take attention of that also. It should not be like that we should just ignore that. If we will ignore that, so the student will, you know, will again he'll get a high and he'll be like, the teacher has not said anything to me, so let's start it again. They play pen fight and stuff like that. This is what they have been saying, and they are busy doing something or the other on the desk, either scribbling, either playing nameless another thing or stuff like that. So they misbehave for several reasons. One might be they are bored. So we need to ensure that our students, they don't get bored. It happens, these students, when they get bored, they don't feel like studying. They don't know the purpose of the presentation. At times it happens that we are not able to, you know, focus on all the students completely. We only teach the students who are just sitting in front or who want to study. It should not be like that. We should keep in consideration, we should take in consideration all the students, and then we should start with our lecture. At times it happens that they don't understand how the information that you are delivering applies to them. So we can make our classroom, make our lecture in a more plain manner. Rather than just giving the theory and just writing the answers on board, we should relate it to our surroundings. We can take the students out. Let's suppose if we are teaching nature. So we can take the students out and we can just, you know, explain them that what exactly nature is. Rather than only teaching about the types of trees, grasses and our environment. This is how portraying with examples and teaching the students with examples makes learning more efficient. And again, it's a two-way process. We need to make sure that student is understanding, and on the other side, he or she has to ask questions as well. At times it happens that instruction is uninteresting. So we need to instruct the students, we need to make our topic in a most interesting manner so that students, they enjoy. Rather than getting bored, they should enjoy that whatever their teacher is teaching, that should be good for them. The pace of the instruction is incorrect. At times we go too fast, but at times we go too slow. So we have to keep all these points in mind. Not enough interaction between the peers. It is very important for a teacher to know his or her students. At times it happens that we don't know some of these students in the class. How can you expect your student to know you? If you don't know your student, how can I expect all these students to know me that my name is this and this if I don't know his name? So that is what. These are some very important points of classroom management. First one is, on the very first day, create classroom rules with your students on day one. On day one, whenever our class is assigned, we have to tell the do's and don'ts, we have to tell the consequences, and we need to tell that these all are the things we will be following in the upcoming session. So that our students also, they get to know that these are all the protocols that we are going to follow. Maintain the classroom rules, routines and schedule, but maintain flexible and leave the room for fun. So it should be, again, fun and frolic should be there in the room, but it should not be like that the students, they start fighting. Teacher has, especially in senior classes, teachers, it is not necessarily important that teacher has to be there in the class the entire day. We should leave the room for fun, but we should make sure that students should not, you know, cross their limits. When students are engaged and excited about learning, less management problems arise. Now, these are some tips that the students should follow. Say please and thank you. This should be followed by us also and by the students also. It is always, good to say please and thank you. Do words bolne mein hamara kuch nahi jata hai, na? Be polite. It's good to be polite. Just because the other person is taking whatever you are saying and he's going to discuss all that with the other people. Raise your hand for students. They should always raise their hand and answer rather than answering in groups. Follow rules. It is for students also, and again for us also, there are some protocols that are being made for the smooth functioning of the school or for the class. So it is always good to follow rules. Share with others if we have a problem. If I am sharing it with others and if the other person is listening, so you know that might lower down my anger. So it is always good to share with others, and for students also, students should be teacher's friend and teachers should be students' friend, and the students share their problems or any other personal problems. Students, they do have personal problems, so we should maintain such kind of relationship with these students that these students, you know, they feel free to interact with their teachers and they feel free to discuss everything with their teachers. Take turns, which is very important. As discussed, it should not be like that only one student is answering or one student is doing everything. be it anything, be it, if we talk about morning assembly, being teachers, it should not be like that, that if a student is speaking nicely or fluently, if he has got good communication skills, he or she will only be given chance for morning assembly. Rather, we should pull up other students also, and we should motivate other students also, just because stage, everybody wants to go on stage, especially students. So we need to motivate slow learners, and we need to, you know, make them stand on the stage so that their confidence level goes up and their personality improves. So that's all for today. Any queries? KK sir, anything else you want to ask?
It was really interesting.
I hope it will be beneficial for all of us. I tried to cover most of the points. Right, so
thank you, ma'am.